Abraham was 100 years old and Sarah was 90. And in the natural sense, it could not be that they would produce a child. But God said, at this appointed time, I'm coming back, and you'll see what I say will come to pass.
Glory to God.
I have found out through the years when I found myself in situations that were literally impossible. But God did the possible. But what did I say? I said what God said. If God said by his stripes, you are healed, you are healed.
Amen.
If God said he will supply all of your needs according to his riches and glory, it's already done. I don't care where the needs come from. It may come from the milkman. It may come from the butcher. It may come from the baker. But I don't care where it comes from, because God is the provider and God has given us everything he said. And then in the third verse, and Abraham called the name of his son that was born unto him, whom Sarah bare to him, Isaac. See, we have to call what God says into existence. We have to believe God to the point we speak what he says. We have to believe God, whatever God has said. When the doctor shakes his head and walks away from your bed and says, you have 2 weeks to live because you have cancer. But God says, by my son's stripes, you are healed. I'm calling myself healed. I'm not going to say I have cancer because God said I'm healed. When the bank account says 0.0 and I don't see any money in my bank account, but God said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken, neither their seed taking bread. I'm going to say, I have what God said. Every need is met according to his riches and glory by Christ.
Glory to God.
So
hallelujah.
What God says, it's already done.
It's already done.
You need to call that God has spoken. Call it what it is, not what somebody else has said. The fourth verse, in Abraham circumcised his son Isaac, being 8 days old. 8 represents the day of completion and beginning. 7 is the day of completion, but 8 is the day it's finished. And so there has to be an act of faith when God speaks something in your life. If he says, I'm about to give you some transportation and you don't have anything in the garage but junk, you need to clean the junk and get ready to receive what
Glory.
God says. When God says, I'm going to give you some brand new furniture, you need to start giving the old furniture away and preparing for the new furniture. Whatever
my God,
says,
my God.
He gives instructions.
Yes, glory to God.
What instruction is he giving you? Mm. He told him on the 8th day, I want you to circumcise him. What does circumcision mean? It's a mark of consecration. It's a mark of dedication. It's a mark of sanctification. That what has happened is mine.
My God,
when God gives you something, it's not just for you. It's for a testimony of praise. It's for a testimony of worship. And you need to circumcise it. You need to let the world know that God did that when it was impossible, when nothing seemed to be going my way. But I want you to know God said, I'm healed, and I am healed. Hallelujah to Jesus.
Glory to God.
I was going through situations and being attacked in a body, and we just agree. It doesn't matter what they say, it doesn't matter what they think. When we go to the doctor, it's all going to be, you're healed.
Glory
to
God.
Well. You're delivered. And she got a report, and I said, I'm not surprised.
Yeah, God.
I'm just grateful.
Glory to God.
You shouldn't be surprised when God speaks.
Glory to God. Yeah.
We should be grateful.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
My God, I have something to let you know that God is saying to all of us in this particular time that we're living in. We're living in crucial times. We're living in times where the world is going havoc and crazy. We're living in times where marriage covenants are not being honored by God's word. Husbands are men and wives are men, and men are marrying men, and women are marrying women. And my God, they're killing babies before they're born. But God is still on the throne. He's still in control.
Glory to God.
He still has spoken that in the last days,
glory,
things will happen.
Jesus.
In the last days, perilous times will come.
That's what he said.
My God, but what are you going to do in perilous times? And I want to close this part of my story with John 6 and 38. For I came down from heaven,
my God,
not to do my own will.
Glory to God.
But hey, the will of him that sent me.
Glory to God.
I want you to know your life is not your own.
Amen.
You have been bought with a price. Everything that God has given you is for his glory. Everything that God has spoken into your life is to bring glory to honor to him. Not your titles, not your position, not your education, to build up the flesh. Whatever he has placed you in this world to do is to bring forth his will. His will
glory
is
to God.
His purpose for your life.
Yes.
And as we close, listen to this. And this is the Father's will. I want to know what the will is.
Glory to God.
I don't want to guess about it. I want to hear what he says. And this is the Father's will. Listen to this. Which has sent me. Now, the Father's will was to send Jesus.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Into this world. That's the Father's will. He wanted Jesus to be our perpetuation. He wanted Jesus to connect us back to God. He wanted the fallen man that had the sin nature to be made righteous through his son.
Yes.
He wanted us to be reconciled back to him. Because when he created man, he created him in his image and in his likeness.
That's
I'm
right.
Getting ready to close now.
Glory
but listen to this. And he's that of all which he has given me. Now, listen to this. The Father is saying, I sent my son that I might give you in your sinful nature a gift to him. Now, knowing the biblical operations of sacrifice, sacrifices had to be perfect. They could not be blemished. There couldn't be nothing that was out of order in the sacrifice. So the Father's will is saying, son,
glory,
I'm giving Blanche and Odell and all of you, I'm giving you to Jesus.
Glory to God.
And as I present you to Jesus, he's going to have to do something about it in order for you to be the perfect gift. So what did he do for us? He was wounded for our transgressions.
Glory to God.
He was
hallelujah.
For our iniquities.
Yes.
And the chastisement
glory to God
was upon him.
Yes.
And with his stripes,
glory. Yes.
He went to the garden.
Hallelujah.
And like blood came out to secure
glory to God, yeah. Glory to God.
Did you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
My God, you don't have to worry about your decisions any longer. He said, don't give them any thought. You just seek the kingdom.
Glory
the
to God.
The kingdom is allowing your body to be a living
hallelujah
sacrifice to him because he took a gift that needed to be woo put back in order.
Glory,
and
go ahead, Bishop.
He came into redemption that we, the gift that God
glory to God.
Be because
glory to God.
He took us as his gift.
Yes.
My God, and I'm getting ready to close with that same verse. Now, here we are in perfected gifts that the Father has given Jesus.
Yes.
To perfect us.
Glory to God.
He goes to the cross.
Uh-huh.
He gives himself.
Go ahead, Bishop.
God raises him from the dead.
Yes.
The
hey, God.
My God, he raises him from the dead.
Jesus.
That we might be the perfect sacrifice.
Hey, God.
My God, that we might represent him in this sin, sick, dead, guzzling, dope addict.
Glory to God.
World, not how big your car is, not how big your home
oh,
is.
Oh, God.
How can you serve him? You can serve him in spirit and in truth.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God.
I think I got one more minute.
Thank you, God.
Hallelujah. And so I should lose nothing.
Yes.
But should raise it up again.
That's it, Bishop. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God.
You've been raised.
Jesus.
Because he was raised.
Glory to God.
There is nothing you should worry
glory
about.
Glory to God.
Because God promised Jesus that I am going to give you as a gift. And he's going to take that gift and clean you up and wash you and perfect
glory
you.
Glory to God.
That you might represent him in this last and evil day. I want you as I close to begin to see the love of God, the peace of God, the joy of God, because God has chosen you.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
I don't care what state we've been in.
Glory to God.
I don't care if you've been a prostitute. I don't care if you've been a drug addict. I don't care what walk you've been. God said before he saved you, I am giving you to my son. And his son went to the cross that gift in the hand of Messiah. Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Jesus.
I'm going to live every
oh,
day.
Oh, God.
I'm going to praise him every day.
Thank you,
I'm
Jesus.
Gonna
glory
day.
To God.
I'm going to glorify him
oh,
every
oh, yes, Lord.
Because he has spoken it.
Yes.
And when he's spoken, it's done. And what I'm going to do with what he's spoken, I'm going to walk
hey,
out.
God.
Hey,
God. Hey, God. Jesus! Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus! Glory to God! Hey, God!
Already born.
My God! My God!
Thank God for the spoken word of God.